Hello everyone. In this video, I will introduce and explain Feign. What is the Feign? It's a declarative HTTP client developed by Netflix. Basically, it makes writing the web service clients easier. For the demonstration, I have two simple microservices. I will show on that projects. Let's open the first one. The first application is a simple Spring Boot REST API, and I'm gonna use in-memory database for saving my entities. And this is the connection URI, and this is the README. You can check it how to run the project basically. And let's go to the controller. What it does basically, it save a user, get a user by ID, and get a user by email. You can add more methods like delete, update. Basically, we are gonna test only these methods. Also, you can add another controller for user twists, but I will not do that now. Basically, I have a user, that's it. And open the Bootstrap here if you want to save some users like me before starting the application. I want to test these two users. You can add more users also. Let's open the properties. This is the DB configuration. And then I want to open the first one. This application starts from port 88. Let's see if I started. It's already running. Okay. Let's open the browser. And let's say localhost 8080. And I want to show all the users. As you see, I have two users. I display two users. And the second method, I want to get a user by ID. It's also the second method. For the post, we can use postman and send the request actually. Here, if we send it, let's see, this is the second API. It's running. Later on, I will show that part. Okay, we tested first part. Let's open the second application. The second one is Feign client. What it does, basically before running this project, you need to run the first one. If you don't have, you can clone the project from the GitHub and then run the second project. In this project, we don't have the database. Actually, I can remove this part. Okay. And let's open the client, the important part. Before this, let's open the main class. You have to enable Feign clients before running the application. And after that, you can declare your Feign methods. Like here, this is the Feign imports. You can use Spring Cloud imports, but in that case, it behaves a little bit differently. You can check the differences. And by default, I'm using the Feign client annotations. This annotation is a Spring Cloud application, OpenFeign. But you can override it inside the config. What I did here, I'm using the default annotations for the Feign. This being basically override this part. And open the class again. What it does, it gets a user by email, get all the users, save a user, and also find by ID. We are gonna call the previous microservices and test how to do that. If you used REST template before, it's almost same, but here we are only declaring the interface and we are not touching any codes. It's basically does everything for us in runtime. If you want to override this part, you can change with your APIs, you can test it. For now, we are going to localhost 8080. I'm gonna start this application from another port since the first is 8080. Let's open here. If you want to change another port, just change this port. It's 8081, the second one. And okay, what it needs actually, it needs a Spring Cloud Feign version. This is, you can add this dependency management part and use the Feign. Also for the configuration, I add some more dependencies. The Feign core, Feign HTTP, and for mapping JSON, you can change it actually. If you check the documentation, you can see the differences, what you need. And for testing, I have a Feign config class. I'm gonna use this for test, my unit test. What it does, it creates a configuration file for me, and I configure it with these parameters. Also, I'm gonna call the users. And I have a simple test method. Okay. But before setup, I'm creating a bin user client. I'm gonna use this client since. And the first test is return all the users. Now there are two users. I'm gonna check these two users. Also, I'm gonna check one user by email. I'm gonna check one user by ID. Also, I'm gonna save one user. But after the first time, if you save this user, the second time it will fail because you already have this user, the duplicate email in the other side. Server side, we are checking the duplicate. And you cannot run this test twice. Let's run the tests. I want to run one by one actually. Let's first run this one. Okay, as you see, user is saved. I have a user, and let's get a user, the first user. Okay, it returns my user as you see here. User one, I'm calling behind the scenes, it calls this API. And it returns the user, and I'm logging the user here. Okay, I want to ignore this test for after the first step. Let's run all the methods, see if it is working. Yes, you can see all tests is passed. Also, we can test actually run the application. I create a simple controller here. Let's say we want to call second API and show something to user. And here I have a user controller. Okay. What it does, it calls the user client, and user client behind the scenes call the second API and get all the users. Also, I'm getting a user by ID. And let's run the application first. Okay, as you saw, application start port 8081. It's a different port. Let's open the UI, and I think the mapping is same. Let's check it first and go to the user controller here. It's /users/users user ID, and the port is 8081. And users, first let's get the users, let's see if it is working. Yes, it is. As you saw, it's calling the first API actually, But if we call this first API, it's almost same. Okay. And 8080. I want to call this. Yes. Behind the scenes, the first one, the 8081, call the second API, gets users and show us. And let's test the second method. Get the ID, let's second, let's third. Yes, all is working. In this API, actually, we did not implement something. Let's assume the second API is not working, and the first one calling the second, in that case, it will fail. I will not show that part how it works. And I hope it helps. Thank you for watching.